Hello friends, so now today we'll see the first and follow concept which is related to parser. So what is first and follow? Before that, some of the concepts we have to clear, that is what is terminal and non-terminal. So these are the two concepts that we have to know before we learn the first and follow concept. So terminal, which is nothing but the end symbols which cannot be further extended, and they are going to terminate. That's why they are known as a terminal. After that, what do you mean by non-terminal? Non-terminal are nothing but these capital letters. You can say them as a variable. You can recognize them as variables also. And non-terminals are the terminals or are the symbols which are going to terminate, which are not producing any new terminals. And in above example, as we have given or we have seen one example, that A stands to ABC, small ABC, where A is a non-terminal symbol, means it is going to produce new values, that is ABC, and ABC are the terminal symbols which are not going to produce new one values. So these are the terminals which are going to end that string. So A in above symbol is a non-terminal, means they can produce some terminals which are not going to terminate. Okay, they are continuing in the continuing fashion, or they will produce some rules or some new values. So symbols like small case a to z, or symbols like plus, minus, multiplication, division, brackets or identifier, that is ID, are nothing but the terminals. Okay, they are known as the terminals. And symbols like capital A to Z are known as a non-terminal. Okay, so I think all of you get the better idea about the terminal and non-terminal now. So if or whenever we are solving any of the examples, you should know the what are the terminals and non-terminal in your given grammar. So one of the example we'll see here, that is one grammar is given. What does it mean? A tends to A, small a, capital B, slash or pipe symbol, and epsilon. What does it mean? A produces one value, that is AB, and A also produces one value, that is epsilon. Epsilon means nothing. This is the grammar. A tends to AB slash epsilon. A tends to AB and A tends to epsilon. So it means, what does this statement means? A produces two values, AB and epsilon. These two values will be produced by the A. Now first and follow can be done for non-terminal. Okay, we will work or for first and follow, that will be solvable if we are working on non-terminal only. They are not working or they are not for terminal symbols. Okay, so there are some cases. We'll see case by case how these are the first and follow will implemented. So we'll see the first cases now. First case, case one for first concept. What is the first concept and what is the follow concept? Amongst that, we'll see the first concept and case one. If A tends to A alpha, so there are two symbols from A, A and alpha. So whatever the symbol which terminal symbol comes first in while deriving the non-terminal, that is A. So first of A is nothing but A, that is your case one, means you are getting non-terminal symbol at the first time, or that is nothing but the first of your A, that is variable A. After that, case two, what is this, what is case two? A tends to epsilon. Epsilon means null, that you have to remember always. Epsilon is null. So first of A is epsilon, that is null value. This is your grammar source variable, or you can say starting variable. Okay, and it tends to null value, then it is it indicates, or first of A in this case is null. It is possible in first only. Then case 3, what is the case 3? In case 3, what you see, that A tends to B, B tends to C, and C tends to ID. ID is nothing but identifier, that is terminal symbol. It terminates that sequence. So first of A, at that time, what we have to do? First of A, is there any terminal symbol is there? No. So what is the B? So what B tends to C? Again, it is not a terminal symbol. So we have to go or we search for the C. Then we got the ID. So that's why first of A is ID. Terminal symbol is the only first of your variable. It should be a only terminal symbol. So till we get the terminal symbol, we have to find out what should be the first of A, and we have to search out till the depth of that we are getting the terminal symbol. So this is the case 3. What is the case 1? Case 1 is very simple. As you are getting at the first position terminal symbol, that's why first of A is A. In case 2, if it is null, means epsilon, that is your first of A, that is null symbol, epsilon symbol. And in case 3, means you have to follow the, you have to go for next one variable. Again, your next one variable tends to another one variable. Then last one variable tends to ID, that is identifier. It is nothing but the, your identifier is nothing but the terminal symbol. That's why first of A is ID. So these are the three cases for first. So it is very easy. I think all of you got the concept how to find out the first of variable. Okay, we'll see some examples on first. Okay, so this is the sample grammar given. A tends to terminal A, then B tends to in bracket C and ID, C tends to star T and epsilon. Okay, this is the grammar given. So we'll find out what things we are going to find out. We are finding out the first of variables. We always find out grammar of or first of variables. That is nothing but whatever written on left side, whatever you have written on left side, that is A, B and C. So first of A is directly given, that is terminal symbol A. That is very simple. So that's why it is first of A. Then first of B, as we can see here, B tends to C and B tends to ID also, but B tends to C in bracket. So that's why opening bracket is the first of B, as well as second ID, that is second solution for B. There are two solutions, B tends to C and B tends to ID. That's why opening bracket as well as ID both are the first of B. Then first of C, first of C is nothing but the star T and epsilon. So first we got the star, that is terminal symbol, as well as the second solution is epsilon. That's why we have taken star and epsilon in first of C. That is nothing but the concept of first. Now follow concept. I think with this example, you are all of you are clear with the first concept, how to find out first of variables and how to solve these examples. Now we'll see the concept of follow. Here also some cases you have to remember. Follow is nothing but you have to find out after variable. Like case 1 is given, A is a variable which tends to alpha, capital B and beta, and beta tends to A. Now follow of B we have to find out. So what is after B? Who is following B? That is beta. And what beta tends to? A. Means first of beta, the particular terminal or variable following to B, whose first is nothing but the B's follow. So follow of B is nothing but A. For example, here we have taken like A tends to T E dash, and E dash tends to plus F slash ID. So if you want to follow the T, if you want to follow T, if you want to find out follow of T, where what is the follow of T? Next symbol E dash, and E dash tends to, is there any symbols or how to find out the follow of T? Then E dash first. E dash first means this plus symbol. As we know how to find out the first of any variable or any symbol, so this E dash tends to plus F and ID, means I plus and ID both are the first of E dash. That's why follow of T is plus and ID. Are you getting? So TE dash is the grammar given by A and we want to find out follow of T. So what is the next symbol to T? That is E dash. So we have to find out E dash first. So what is the E dash first? That is plus symbol and ID. That's why follow of T we are getting plus and ID. Now case 2. Case 2, what happens in case 2? So A tends to alpha, B and beta. Beta tends to epsilon, that is null. So it indicates beta tends to null. That's why beta it's not available. Null is nothing but the zero value, or you can consider only grammar up to alpha and B. That's why it will look like A tends to alpha B. Then follow of B we have to find out. Follow of B, after B there is no symbol, means all follow of B, all the symbols which are available or following A are nothing but the follow of B. So in follow, in concept of follow, epsilon will not be there. As we have seen, epsilon is available in first concept, but in follow epsilon will not be there. Anytime we have, you have to note this point, that in follow epsilon will not be there, that is null symbol is not there. Next one example. For example, E tends to TE dash, follow of E we have to find out. That as you have seen, there is no symbol available, so dollar is the symbol, or we have given that follow of E dollar and opening bracket. Then suppose we want to find out E dash, then as there is no symbol after E dash, so it will follow, or it will take all the follower of the E, that is source symbol. So that is nothing but the dollar and opening bracket. Then case 3 is given, like A tends to alpha, B beta. Beta tends to A and epsilon. Means what? Beta tends to A as well as beta tends to epsilon. So it will also implies that A tends to alpha B only. Beta, if we go for epsilon, then that time it will only gives you alpha and B. But whenever you are considering this solution, beta goes to A, that time it will be available with there. So then follow of B is equal to A comma, means follow of B you are going to finding out. So beta after B, beta is the symbol, so that's why beta's first, that is A symbol, that is available. After that we have to, next one solution for beta is epsilon. So if epsilon is gone, only this statement will be remaining. So alpha beta, alpha B, then after B there is no symbol, so all follow of A are the list of the follow of B. Means follow of B gives you result A comma all the follow of A. Okay, that is the case 3. Now we'll see examples. On first and follow. This is the first one example, or in next video we'll start with the examples.